Guys, I messed up. I admit it. I messed up. What is up, YouTube? Flourish RLC, and I'm back with my Kansas City Chiefs franchise here on Madden 16. And I don't know how I did it, but I managed to upload, I did the commentary and uploaded the San Diego Chargers game before the Oakland Raiders game. Technically, this game, as you can see right there, is supposed to be before the Chargers game. And I don't know how I did it. I titled them incorrectly in my capture card. And you guys are going to see this after it was supposed, like, this was supposed to be San Diego game, today. But instead, I accidentally posted the Chargers game first. That's kind of going to spoil it a little bit. But I still had to bring this to you guys. You know, I said I was going to bring you guys every game. That's exactly what I'm doing. So we're here in Oakland facing the dreaded Oakland Raiders. it's always fun facing Oakland because most of the times we smack them around. So it's always fun smacking the Oakland Faders around, even though the Raiders are probably going to be pretty good this next year. I'm not looking forward to that because their fans are going to, like, come out of nowhere to, you know, like, talk shit like, you know, you haven't won anything since, like, 2002. But, hey. I'm just saying. I mean, I know. As a Chiefs fan, I probably shouldn't be talking too much just because we haven't really, this is really the first year we've really done anything, and we didn't even really make it that far. It's like our first playoff win, and Jesus knows how long. But, the Oakland Raiders should be good this next year in real life. I hope they're not. I would always love the Raiders to suck and for us to be better than them. I would always love that, but that's not going to always happen, you know. Occasionally, they might be a little bit better than us. It's whatever. So I figure with this series a little bit, I don't know, I could kind of like turn like the first half or so into these games, kind of just like a rambling thing. I just kind of just ramble on as you guys watch and you guys can follow along. And look at Tyvon Branch getting an amazing pick six. Not a pick six. Wow, what am I talking about? Getting an amazing pick. That was absolutely spectacular how he jumped that route, got right in front of the ball. And if my memory serves me correctly, because again, I haven't played these games in about a month or two, and I edited the videos a while ago, I think Smith got hurt in the San Diego game. So this will be like the last you guys see of him like actually like starting, you know what I mean? But we do find Travis Kelce across the middle of the field for a big first down to the 15. Then we're going to give the toss to Jamaal Charles. He kind of gets caught up behind some blockers, but, you know, hey, it's whatever. You win some and you lose some, right? Third down, we're going to find a first down to, I believe that's Jeremy Maclin, another big first down. I'm telling you, the wide receivers have actually been good, you know? I mean, in the past, our wide receivers haven't been that good, as that should have been a touchdown, but no, Wilson just stepped out of bounds at the end. So, second down and goal, what are we going to do? Giving it to Jamaal Charles, who's going to power his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas City, and the Chiefs take the early 7-0 lead here in the first quarter. Charles doing his patented brush down or shake down, brush off, whatever you want to call it. I think that what I'm going to do, because you guys, as you guys probably know, if you don't, I don't know where you've been. I'm just kidding. I'm doing a series on MLB 16 The Show with the Arizona Diamondbacks. I figured what I'm going to try to do. Now, again, I'm going to try. That doesn't necessarily mean I'm going to do it, but I'm going to try to do this. I'm going to try to alternate the days. Like, today you guys will get the Chiefs. Tomorrow, the Diamondbacks. The day after that, the Chiefs. And I'm going to alternate it day in, day out. One day you'll get the Chiefs, then next day you'll get the Diamondbacks, and then I'll just, you know, keep going on from there. That's what I'm going to try to do. I'm going to try to do that. I don't know if it'll work. I don't know if I'll end up doing it. That's what I'm going to try to do. And you pretty much can expect all these franchise games pretty much go around about noon to 1 o'clock p.m. Central Time. You can differentiate time zones depending on where you live, but that's pretty much what you guys can expect. You know, you guys can expect for these videos to pretty much be around noon to 1 o'clock Central Standard Time each and every day. So you can see the CPU once again being dumb and like running right into blockers and not picking up first down. Again, that's my biggest beef with this game, like offline. The CPU is just dumb as shit. I don't understand why, but the CPU just plays stupid. So, Marquette King, best punter in the game. He got a 99 in Mutt. Like, you know, it's kind of funny and kind of weird. Marquette King, who's a punter, and again, he's a good punter. Don't get me wrong. He's a great punter. But he has a 99, and the likes of Lawrence Taylor, Jerry Rice don't have one. We don't have a Steve Young does have one. Never mind. You know, and there's a bunch of other people that are actual legends that don't have, like, 99 overall card. But hell, you know what? They gave Tebow a 99, so you know what? I who else would they give a 99 to? It wouldn't surprise me one bit. Getting picked off by Charles Woodson, that didn't surprise me either, you know? It doesn't matter what team he's on, I'm always gonna respect the hell out of that man. Now he's retired, but I love Charles Woodson. One of my favorite players. Like, whenever we play the Raiders, I just like to watch him, to be honest. Like, he's really the only player on the Raiders that I'm okay with doing well, because I just love Charles Woodson. I mainly was a fan of him first when he played with the Packers, because my sister is a huge Packers fan. Shout out to Brittany. So, you know, watching games with her, you know, I really started to see Charles Woodson and just the way that he played. I just fell in love with the way that he played, you know, and I respect the hell out of him, and he's a great player. So, he picked off there. They have ball in good field position, but Justin Houston getting a big sack on that last play. That was definitely neat. We definitely need to make a big play there, get a big sack, pushing them back down now to second down and 14. Under pressure, firing it down the field, and this one going to be batted down, but there's a penalty. Please don't be defensive pass interference. Just please don't be pass interference. No, it's pass interference. Of course it is. On Eric Berry. Yeah, okay, that's... I kind of halfway expected that. I mean, it's just like eventually stuff like that's going to happen. And but again, luckily the CPU... just dumb as hell, so I don't really expect them to get into the end zone. Guess what? They don't. They have a wide open hole, and they decided to just keep running to the outside. Like, again, I don't understand. Like, why? Like, I mean, I wish the CPU was a little bit smarter. Even on all Madden, CPU is kind of dumb. And MLB The Show, the CPU is actually kind of smart. Like, the CPU actually makes good decisions. And in this game, the CPU is just stupid. I don't understand why. So, getting into the second quarter there, they're settled. They're forced to settle for just a field goal. And, you know, so far things are going good. The offense, you know, we did throw that pick, but that was just a good play by Charles Woodson. The defense, again, doing great. They were kind of put in a bad spot there. So, you know, can't really expect them to always get that stop. But the defense, again, we're ranked number one in the NFL. I say it every video because I have to point it out. Number one ranked defense in the NFL. How could you not brag about that? To be honest, you know, it's absolutely amazing. They're, you know, our defense is balling out. They make all those plays. You saw Branch made that pick earlier in the game. Just absolutely spectacular. Now I'm just waiting for Peters to get a pick. Like, I know it's coming. You guys know it's coming. Peters gets a pick almost like every single game, so you guys can already expect that. So a little bit of play action with Smith. Gonna find Travis Kelce for, I think, first down, almost a first down, maybe second and one, whatever. Giving the ball now once again to Jamal Charles, hitting the outside. Jamal Charles trying to pick up some extra yards. Still picking up the first down to the 27-yard line now. Charles, I believe, 16 yards on the day so far. First and 10, once again, dropping back to throw. Going to find, I believe that's Chris Conley for another big first down to the 48-yard line. And again, the push for the playoffs is real right now. You know, I mean, we're still, like, in command. I mean, we haven't lost a game yet. So, you know, I don't really know if we're going to lose a game or not. You can see Smith just rumbling, bumbling, and stumbling for a first down to the 36, holding on to the ball. That is what I was the most surprised about. I thought for sure that Smith was going to, whoops, fumble, you know, butterfingers, but not me, held on to the ball. And then Jamal Charles, a great run right there, getting us down to the 14. And things once again looking bright for the offense. You know, we still got a lot of time left in the quarter, so our offense is moving pretty damn good right now. Gonna find Travis Kelce for another touchdown. Touchdown Kansas City, extending our lead now to 14-3. And Kelce has had a breakout year. Kelce's had a phenomenal year. I've absolutely loved what I've seen out of him so far. He's just been a great go-to target. And just spectacular. I mean, everything right now is going pretty well. Again, I kind of wish the offense was still a little bit better, but I'll still take the performance that they're giving. You know, our offense is still getting the job done. They're going out there, they're getting scores, and we're winning games. I mean, that's really all I can ask. You know, I can't really ask for much more. You know, and look at that big hit. Tyvon Branch is making a lot of plays so far today in this game. You can see laid out that big hit right there. So 3 minutes left to go now in the half. I believe they get ball at half. We might. Actually, I think we get ball at half. I don't even remember. I know it was like 10 minutes ago. I don't even remember who gets ball at half. But if we get ball at half, then I think you might be able to say this game's over. But if they get ball at half, then, you know, there's still some room. There's still some room for them to make some plays. So third down and three. Derek Carr looking for an open receiver and going to find it. Just barely skimmed it through there. Eric, Barry, and Peters were both there on the coverage. But Cooper able to just haul that one in, barely. Lucky for them, right? First down and 10. Now, once again, Carr back to throw. A lot of time in the pocket. Almost no pass rush. Tries to roll out of the pocket. But Mike DeVito is going to be there for the sack. I believe just his first sack on the year. Not a very good year for Mike DeVito. You know, DeVito hasn't really done much. You guys have probably seen Jay Howard has been in for him a lot. Even though technically on our depth charts, DeVito is our starting right end. But he just hasn't done anything, really, so a lot of times I just put Jay Howard in. So it was good to see DeVito get that sack, and then Tom Bahali coming around the edge, getting another sack on Derek Carr. Now, Carr does have a good amount of time in the pocket, but we're not really getting, like, we have gotten a couple of sacks, but we kind of got there a little late, you know? Like, they still had plenty of time back there in the pocket to throw. We just had some really great coverage. So the minute and a half left before half, we have a chance now to extend our lead to 21-3. And again, with the way that our defense is, I wouldn't expect us to blow a lead like this. I just do not. Like, that's how confident I am in my defense. We're going to try to throw it up deep to, I believe that's Conley. And Conley somehow comes down with the catch. That one bobbled around and Conley's got it down to the 9. I'm telling you, this kid has a lot of potential. I mean, I'm excited for next year. I'm excited for the playoffs with this kid because this kid makes plays. Like, he's 6'3". He's got the height. He's got the speed. He's got the physicality. He's just got all of the tangibles that I like in my wide receivers. You know, just got to build up that blocking a little bit. He'll be a monster. Trust me, okay? The next couple of years for Conley, because, you know, I plan to do this series for a couple of, you know, like, I plan to do a couple of seasons. It's kind of their drop the pass. I probably would have gone for it had he caught that. We would have been down to, like, the 2 or the 1. So I probably would have gone for it. But we'll take a field goal, go into half with a 14-point lead, and we might get ball at half. I don't know. We're going to go to halftime with a 14-point lead. Pretty dominant so far. Again, the defense making all the right plays. But, yeah, so I plan to do a couple seasons of this. Hell, I plan to pretty much do it until Madden 17 comes out. And, that's going to be a while, you know. And at the rate I'm posting these videos, I might get a good, like, 6 or 7 seasons in. I'm not sure. So far, I've only played the first season through. Haven't even touched the second season yet. I'm pretty much waiting to post all of these because I don't want to, like, commit too early. I want to, like, post all of these. Then I'll go into the next year and then post all those. I don't want to be like 4 seasons ahead of you guys. Like, I just feel like it's a little bit unfair. I'll just forget everything that happens. So, yes, you know, I'm probably just going to, you know, stay probably 1 off season ahead, you know, or something like that. I don't know. I remember one night, I think it was before I left for Arizona like a month ago. I pretty much binge played like the entire like second half of the season in like one night because I knew that on the plane I could edit like all these. Like, I didn't get around to editing all of them, but I got around to editing most of them. So I was like, on the plane I can do that. In the hotel when I'm bored, I can do that. I can just edit the video. So I just like binge played these games because, you know, these games are around like 45 minutes to like an hour long, so they take a little bit longer to edit. So we're going to receive the ball at half now, and with a chance to take a 21-point lead here after half. Assuming we get a touchdown on this drive. Again, assuming. I don't know. Our offense is just kind of sporadic. One drive, they'll be just lights out. No one can touch them. The next drive, it's just absolute trash. So, I don't know. It's, you know, our offense is like, they kind of have a bit of an identity crisis. They don't quite know who they are. So we're going to bring the offense back out onto the field now. So, first play. And this one going to be picked off by Nate Allen. He's going to pick 6 this. Like, damn it. That is not what I plan to do. Like, he just jumped straight down on that ball. Jesus Christ. That was bad. Like, very first play from scrimmage of the half, just totally just comes down and picks 6s me. Now, all of a sudden, it's a 7-point game. I was talking about taking a 21-point lead. Now, you know, I'll be lucky to, no, it's not a 7-point game. Yeah, it actually is. I'll be kind of lucky to, you know, get a 2-possession lead here. It's a 1-possession game. They get another pick. Boom, they're right back into this game. So, hopefully the offense can not, like, fall apart here, not melt down. We haven't really had like a total offensive or defensive meltdown this year so far, and I would rather it not be to the Raiders. I'm not gonna lie, I do not want to lose to the Raiders. Okay, like, you know, the Chargers. If, like, say I lost to the Chargers, it wouldn't affect me. If I lost to the Broncos or the Raiders, it would just it would upset me. Like, I'd be upset because I know there'd probably be one Broncos fan or one Raiders fan in the comment that would, like, talk crap. So I don't want to lose. I don't want to have to deal with that. And look at Charles Woodson getting another pick. And I said we haven't had an offensive meltdown. This is a bit of an offensive meltdown. We're about to blow a 14-point lead at half. Granted, they get a touchdown on this drive. So, man, like, I thought I had that play too, but Woodson, again, jumping right in front of it. Just three hard luck picks, I would say. You know, I wouldn't say these were horrible reads. They probably were, but I wouldn't say they're bad reads. Just some tough luck picks for Smith. So AS11, not looking too sharp right now. Now, the Raiders, luckily it's 3rd-and-1, and I know that 3rd-and-1, the CPU's probably going to run it. And they're going to be stupid and run into their own blockers. Or they're going to call a QB option and not pick up the first down. So, they actually did pick up the first down. I thought it would be 4th-and-inches and the CPU would punt the ball as usual. So, 1st-and-10, fresh set of downs. Now 3 minutes left to go now in the third. Handing it off once again to Jones. And Jones trying to power through, breaking off some tackles. And the Raiders right now, they're looking to at least come away with a field goal. They'd like to tie the game, as would any team. But against our defense, you'll pretty much just look to take whatever we'll give up. I mean, that's pretty much the thing. That's what I love about our defense, is like, we do not give up much. You know, we do not. As they pick up a first down there, kind of tough luck there. And still, man, we're kind of having trouble stopping them on third down so far. A minute 40 left to go. And this one, Carr actually got bumped into his halfback, and that's going to be an inaccurate throw. 2nd-and-10, handing off once again. This one going to get down to, I believe, the 19, the 20. And now we're trying to look if we can't shut them out of the red zone now. So Carr back to pass, 3rd-and-4, looking for someone open. He's going to find his halfback, but that's not going to pick them up a 1st-down, 4th-and-1. And they'll be settled to take a field goal once again for the 2nd time in this game. Like, think about it. If they would have gotten touchdowns instead of field goals, it would be a much different game right now. But the defense, bend don't break, stopping them, holding them to just field goals. So now it's a 4-point game, and things are kind of getting down to the wire here. We're about ready to go into the 4th quarter. And we just need a score. We just need a score right here, right now. Because it's a 4-point game, a field goal at least will make it a touchdown game, but I'm looking to go for the touchdown, kind of maybe put this one out of reach. I don't know, like, I don't feel like they'll be able to move down the length of the field and score. Like, you guys have kind of noticed a theme throughout most of these games this year. Our opponents really only score when we give them good field position, pretty much, you know, off turnover or whatever. They really rarely drive down the field and score. Have you guys ever noticed that? I've noticed that a lot. 3rd-and-4, though, that one, bit of a risky throw, forces a 4th-and-8, and we have to punt the ball back to the Raiders with 6:50 left to go. This is bad. I did not want to lose our first game of the year to the Raiders. True, we're going to the playoffs, and they're not, so that's, you know, the only thing that I have to say is, you know, we're going to the playoffs, and they're not, so that's really all I got to say. We're pretty much a for-sure lock for the playoffs, and the Raiders, you guys are going to be watching from the couch this year. And we get a big sack by Allen Bailey. That was huge, pushing them back down 6 yards to the 8-yard line. That was a big sack. You know, it's a sack on the very first play of a drive that can really dictate a lot of momentum and really win you the battles up there in the trenches. And this one going to be incomplete. Had they caught that, 3rd-and-1 and manageable. But now it's 3rd-and-1 and very long, and a chance for us to get the ball back with 6 minutes left to go at the 8. Carr dropping back to throw, trying to look for someone open, trying to go to the sidelines, and he catches it. But it's not a 1st-and-1, 4th-and-1. So what's the CPU going to do? They're going to do the smart thing, and they're going to punt the ball. You savages that play Madden and you never punt no matter what, this is called strategy. A little bit. Kind of. Actually, I think maybe you would go fourth there. I mean, 1 yard is pretty easy to get in this game because, again, defensive linemen don't play like defensive linemen, and QB sneaks are pretty damn easy. You can see Jamal Charles hitting the juke moves, and maybe it was a bad idea for them to punt the ball back to us because our offense, I don't see them stopping us. I think we got a lot more momentum on our side than they do. We find Jamaal Charles once again out the backfield for another first down, second down, and seven now. 4:20 left to go. There's a flag on the field. Please don't be on us. I'm going to take off with Smith. Smith's got a lot of room. Sliding down to avoid fumbling and avoid injury, because I don't know who the flag's on. Most likely it's holding on us, but you never know. You actually see penalties in franchise. So, yeah. It is going to be on them, actually, though. Luckily, it was. So, we're going to decline the penalty, though, because we got a good chunk of yards on the run with Alex Smith. So, first down and 10. Smith rolling out of the pocket yet again. Doing his best Mike Vick impersonation. And he's hurt. Smith has been, like, just too injury-prone this year. You guys notice that? And he's been the only one that's gotten hurt like all year. I swear, injuries are on. Well, as you guys can tell. But like, none of my players get hurt. It's kind of funny. I do not have to deal with injuries. I just do not. I don't know. I'm pretty fortunate, okay? I'm a good trainer, okay? I train my players well. First down and 10, going to go with the drag route to Chris Conley. Almost picking up the first down now. Down to 3 minutes left to go in the game. Things are looking good for us. Things are looking down for Oakland. Second down and one. We're going to throw it to, I believe that's Macklin, getting down at the 1 yard line. I thought it was going to be if that was a touchdown, I would have been so happy. But that's whatever. Smith comes back into the game. We're going to give the handoff to Spencer Ware. Spencer Ware. And he doesn't get in the end zone. You guys wonder why I don't call Spencer, why I don't put him in the game more, because he does shit like that. Luckily, he finally gets into the end zone on his second attempt. It took him 2 attempts to get 1 yard. Congratulations, Spencer, even though we did just re-sign him in real life, which I actually am really glad that in real life we re-signed Weston Ware, because those two with Charles next year, that's going to be a beastly three-headed monster in the backfield, okay? I know that a lot of people are going to be sleeping on that Royals, not on the Royals, wow, same sporting complex, just wrong sport, so a lot of people are going to be sleeping on the Chiefs, but I think that trio in the backfield is going to make us just deadly and tough to stop, you know, so I can't wait. I honestly cannot wait. So first down and 10, they're trying to muster up some right here, but they're down by 11, a minute and a half left. There's no way. It's not going to happen. And then take a big sack there, and that pushes them back way farther. I'm pretty sure that we can call this game. Can we? Can we not? I'm not quite sure. Car back to throw again. This one, he's going to throw a duck instead of a dot. That was going to be fourth down and 18. Of course, they got to go for it because you really have no choice here. Incomplete pass, and that looks like it's going to end the game with 1:15 left to go in the game. We take over on downs at the 32-yard line. So why not pad a little bit of stats? Chase Daniels rolling out of the pocket looking for someone open. Actually, I think Smith is in the game. Actually, we find Chris Conley, and we get Conley a 100-yard receiving game yet again. And I'm telling you, Conley has just taken over since we put him at that number two spot. He's just been phenomenal. Absolutely love what I've been seeing out of him. Second down and 5, or second down and 15. Giving it to Jamaal Charles, and Jamaal Charles into the end zone, putting the nail in the coffin, getting another touchdown. Again, just padding the stats a little bit, rubbing it in the Raiders' face a little bit right now, and the fans are booing. They're already headed for the exits. I mean, there wasn't a big crowd today anyways because no one wants to see the Raiders. So everyone's already out the door. So it's just, you know, a couple of last plays here. So they're going to find once again another receiver. But again, it's game over. It's 31-13. I think we can call it game over. Third down and 5 again. They're trying out here. They're trying to make something happen. Batted down, incomplete, bringing up fourth down. Are they going to go for it? Are they going to punt? They're going to concede defeat, and they're going to punt. They're waving the white flag like, stop beating us, Chiefs. We get it, Chiefs. You're better than us. Oh, man. So we do end up coming out with the win, still undefeated on the year. And I'm sorry that I showed you guys the Chargers game before this one, but hey, just pretend you didn't see it, okay? Just pretend you did not see it, but now you know, okay? Now you know. I'm pretty sure there was at least one person that was wondering, like, didn't the Chiefs play the Raiders after the Bills and before the Chargers? Yeah, they did. I'm just going to mix it around a little bit just for fun because I felt like this was better scheduling. It makes more sense. Anyway, so hope you guys did enjoy this Madden 16 franchise mode. You guys are actually really liking this. I've seen a lot of people that have been commenting on these videos, and they've actually really been liking it. And I love the support from some of you guys on my MLB videos. You guys do not know how much that means because, to be honest, I was kind of nervous switching over from Madden, which has gotten my channel a lot of success and has really grown my channel, but switching to something else, You know, it's always going to be kind of scary. But you know what? I know that my real fans, the guys that really enjoy my videos, I know that you guys are going to stick around. And I'm really thankful for you guys. Thank you so much. And I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm Fluttershy. Peace out. And as usual, extra long pause. Have a great day, guys.